Welcome to my channel. In this video, we are going to solve some problems from the second unit of the transmission lines and RF system. So already we solved the first unit problem, third unit, fourth unit, and the remaining all units already we solved. If you want to watch that videos, means I will give link in the description box. You can refer it, or in my channel, in the name of transmission lines and RF system, one playlist is that. In that playlist, all lecture videos as well as the 2 mark question and the problems for all units is already posted. Okay, so you can use it. So now we are going to solve the 8 important problems. So all these problems are previously asked in Anna University question paper from this unit 2. Okay, so the unit 2 already, you know, it's a high frequency transmission line. Okay. So we will see the question. So all questions are the previous Anna University questions, 2 mark question, 6 mark, 8 mark, and 10 mark question. Okay. So you see the first question. The first question is a lossless line. So already you know the second unit, it is a high frequency transmission line. The high frequency transmission line is called as lossless line or zero dissipation line or dissipation less line. Okay. So yeah, a lossless line has a characteristic impedance is it not equal to 400 ohm. Okay, determine SWR. So what is SWR? Standing wave ratio. So sometimes instead of SWR, there may given VSWR, voltage standing wave ratio, all are same only. Okay, so determine the standing wave ratio if the receiving end impedance is at or equal to 800 plus J0. So it's a May 2017 question. It's a 2 mark problem. Okay. So in this unit, so the standing wave ratio is a very important problem from this unit. Okay, 2 mark problem. And in first unit, the reflection coefficient. Okay, the calculation. Similarly, is that not is that are given means how to find the reflection coefficient? It is a very important 2 mark question from the first unit. Okay. So now you see. So what are all the given data? The two data is given. One is ZR given 800 and characteristics impedance Z naught is 400. Okay, so you know the formula for standing wave ratio. The standing wave ratio S is equal to 1 plus K divided by 1 minus K. Okay, so this is the relation between standing wave ratio and reflection coefficient. So first, if you want to find out the standing wave ratio, first you should know the K value. Okay, what is K? K is nothing but reflection coefficient. So that's why first we have to calculate the reflection coefficient. The reflection coefficient formula already you know, it's a ratio ZR minus Z naught by ZR plus Z naught. Okay, so where ZR is 800 plus J0. Okay, so you know imaginary part minus Z naught is 400. So 800 minus 400 divided by 800 plus 400. So 400 divided by 1200. So the answer is 0.333. Okay. So here the reflection coefficient value is having only the real part, no imaginary part. So that's why if you are converting this reflection coefficient into polar also, we can get a 0.333 with angle 0 degree. Okay. So in order to find out the standing wave ratio, we want modulus of K. So what is modulus of K? In reflection coefficient, this magnitude part. Okay. So from that, modulus of K is equal to 0.333. So you substitute this modulus K value in our SWR formula. So 1 plus 0.333 divided by 1 minus 0.333. So the answer is 1.9998. Okay. So this is the standing wave ratio for the given Z0 and ZR. Okay. So this type of problem is a very repeated question from the second unit. Okay. And you see one more question. Similar to the same thing in November 2016. So you see the 2 mark question, calculate standing wave ratio, okay, and reflection coefficient on a line having the characteristics impedance is it not equal to 300 ohms and terminating impedance is it are equal to 300 plus J400. Okay, so here you see same, okay, similar to the previous problem. In this case also, the characteristics impedance and load impedance is given. Okay, we have to find out standing wave ratio and reflection coefficient. Okay, so for different data. So you see, first you note down the given data, then according to the formula for the reflection coefficient, K equal to zr minus z naught by zr plus z naught. So in previous case, both z naught and zr is real. Okay, so 400 ohm, 800 ohm. Okay, there is no imaginary part. Okay, but in this z naught is real. Zr value is having both real and imaginary. So that's why in K we can get the real part as well as the imaginary part. Okay, so first you substitute the thing. So 300 plus J 400 minus 300 divided by this. So 300, 300, real, real. If you are subtracting, the real part is zero. So J 400 by 300 plus 300, 600 plus J 400. Okay, so here you see, this is the rectangular coordinate divided by some rectangular coordinate. So in your calci, so there are two options in order to solve this type of thing. One is if in your calci, the complex mode is available means, so you directly you divide this one J 400 by 600 plus J 400. So you can get some answer A plus JB. Okay, then that A plus JB answer, you just convert into polar. You can get the answer 0.55 with 56.4 degree. Okay, or otherwise, if the complex mode is not available means, this numerator J 400, the rectangular coordinate, you just convert into polar. Similarly, the 600 plus J 400, you just convert into polar. Okay, so using calci, so if you are converting J 400 into polar, we can get a 400 with angle 90 degree. Okay, similarly 600 with J 400, if you are converting 721.1 with angle 33.6 degree. Okay, so after converting into polar, polar by polar division and multiplication is possible. So you just divide the magnitude part. So 400 divided by 721.1, you just divide. So we can get the answer 0.55. Okay, so here the angles are in division means you just subtract it. So 90 minus 33.6 degree. So the answer is 56.4 degree. So here the reflection coefficient K equal to 0.55 with angle 56.4 degree. Okay, so the reflection coefficient calculated. And next our question is we have to find the standing wave ratio. So you know the standing wave ratio formula, S is equal to 1 plus modulus K divided by 1 minus modulus K. So we have to substitute only the magnitude of reflection coefficient. So from the previous, what is the magnitude of reflection coefficient? 0.55. Okay. So in order to calculate standing wave ratio, we want only the magnitude part. Okay. No need of this angle part. So 1 plus 0.55 divided by 1 minus 0.55. So the answer is 3.44. Okay, this is the standing wave ratio. So the standing wave ratio, it's a number. So no unit. Okay, so this is the second answer. Okay, so in first problem, automatically the reflection coefficient is having only the real part. So that real part is modulus of K. Okay, but here the reflection coefficient is having magnitude part as well as angle part. In order to find out standing wave ratio, we want this magnitude part only. Okay, just neglect this angle part. So you just substitute and find out the answer. Okay, so this is the one type of problem. And the next second type of problem is, so you see it's a November 2015 question. A lossless line has shunt capacitance is 100 picofarad per meter, series inductance 4 microhenry per meter. Calculate the characteristics impedance. Okay, so here for a lossless line, there is high frequency transmission line, the capacitance value, shunt capacitance value, the primary constant RLGC, you know, okay, each transmission line is having the 4 primary constant, in that the capacitance value is given, inductance value is given. Okay, so the question is to characteristics impedance we have to find out. So for lossless line, the characteristics impedance, it's a purely real part. So the characteristics impedance is not equal to square root of L by C. Okay, so for ordinary transmission line, the Z naught is equal to square root of Z by Y. Okay, where Z is a R plus J omega L, Y is a G plus J omega C. Okay, so already we solved the big question problem in first unit problem. Okay, you know, that is the one. In high frequency transmission line, that R value and G value is nearly that is neglected, it is zero. So that's why the Z naught is purely real part. It's a square root of L by C. Okay, so you just substitute the L value. What is L? 4 micro. So 4 × 10⁻⁶ divided by C is 100 pico. 100 × 10⁻¹². Okay, so using Calci, you just calculate. So the answer is 200 ohms. Okay, so this is a one type of 2 mark question. And the next one. So this is a big question problem from this second unit. So you see the question. A line with zero dissipation. Okay, so already that is I told you know that is a dissipationless line, lossless line, line with zero dissipation. All are equivalent to high frequency line. Okay, so a zero dissipation line has R equal to 0.006 ohms per meter, C equal to 4.45 picofarad. L equal to 2.5 micro Henry per meter. Okay, so for a high frequency zero dissipation line, R given usually, you know, for zero dissipation line, R is very, very negligible. So you see the question 0.006 ohms. Okay, so it is negligibly zero. C value given, L value given. If the line is operated at 10 megahertz, the operating frequency is given as 10 megahertz. Find the characteristics impedance, attenuation constant, propagation constant, phase constant, wavelength, and velocity of propagation. So similar to this, so we solved the problems in first unit also. Okay, so but what is the difference between that one and here? Means this is a zero dissipation line. So for zero dissipation line, the R is very negligible, as well as the conductance value G is zero. Okay, so that's why all characteristics impedance formula, propagation, all formulas are reduced into one reduced format. So you may use this zero dissipation line, you may use this these formulas. For ordinary transmission line, we use that first unit formula. Okay, so it's a May 2016 question, big question. So first you note down the given data, R given, C given, L given, and operating frequency given. Okay, so what is the first thing? Characteristics impedance. So for a zero dissipation line, what is the characteristics impedance? Characteristics impedance Z naught equal to square root of L by C. If it is an ordinary transmission line, square root of Z by Y. Z is R plus J omega L. Y is G plus J omega C. Okay, so here you substitute the thing. So 2.5 × 10⁻⁶ divided by 4.45 pico. Okay. So using Calci, you just find the answer 749.53 ohm. Okay, so the real value only it will come. Since for high frequency line, the characteristics impedance is resistive in nature. Okay, then the next one, propagation constant. So the propagation constant, you know, eta equal to square root of Z by, it is nothing but alpha plus J beta. Okay, so for high frequency transmission line, the attenuation constant, this alpha, it is zero. Okay, for zero dissipation line, the attenuation constant is alpha zero. And the phase constant formula is beta equal to omega into root LC. Okay, so you substitute the thing. So omega, if you are expanding 2 pi F, what is F? Here F is given as 10 megahertz. So 10 × 10⁶. Okay, into square root of LC, what is L? 2.5 micro. And C is 4.45 pico. So pico means 10⁻¹². Okay, so you substitute the L and C value. And using Calci, you just find the answer. So the answer is beta equal to 0.2095. So the unit for phase constant, you know, radians per meter. Okay, so for high frequency transmission line, attenuation constant is zero. Phase constant is beta equal to omega into root LC. So therefore, the propagation constant is alpha zero means, so J into beta. So here beta value is 0.2095. Okay, so J 0.2095 is a propagation constant. Okay, so it is calculated. Then the next one, velocity of propagation. So velocity of propagation for lossless liners, the formula is 1 by root LC. Okay, so 1 by, you substitute the L value, C value. So you can get the answer 2.998 × 10⁸. That is 3 into 10, nearly 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. Okay, so it's the velocity of light in air. Okay, then the next one, wavelength. So wavelength formula, you know, wavelength is equal to 2 pi by beta. So 2 pi by the beta value, we derived 0.2095. So 29.9913 meter. Okay, so wavelength is calculated. So for the given R, L, C, here G. For zero dissipation line means automatically the primary constant G is zero. Okay, R is very, very less. It is negligibly zero. Okay, so for that we calculated this parameter. Okay, so it's a one big question. Okay, it's a 113 mark question from the second unit. So it's a May 2016 question. Okay, so this is a one type of problem. And the next one, next question. So you see, this is the different problem. Yeah, this is a May 2016 question. Okay, so 4 mark question. A lossless line has standing wave ratio of 4. Okay, standing wave ratio is given. R naught value is 150. R naught means the characteristic impedance. Okay, so you know, for a high frequency line, the characteristic impedance is that not is purely resistive in nature, which is denoted by R naught. Okay, this is equal to square root of L by C. So R naught is given. And the maximum voltage measured in the transmission line is 135 volt. Okay, find the power delivered to the load. This is a question. So that here, what are the data given? SWR, characteristic impedance, and the maximum voltage is given. So the question is to, we have to find maximum power deliver. So maximum power deliver, you know the formula. It is a V max squared divided by R max. Okay, so here the V max, maximum voltage is given 135. So we have to find out the maximum resistance. Okay, so you know the maximum resistance formula. So at voltage maxima, the impedance is maximum. So the maximum impedance is nothing but the characteristic impedance multiplied with the standing wave ratio. Okay, so in that is the minimum impedance and maximum impedance already we derived in lecture videos. Okay, so the maximum impedance of the high frequency transmission line is the characteristic impedance multiplied with standing wave ratio. So here R naught is 150, standing wave ratio 4. So if you are multiplying, we can get 600. Okay, and you substitute this R max value here. So 135 squared divided by 600. So 30.375 watts. Okay. So this is the answer. So the maximum power delivered is 30.375 watts. Okay, so this is the one type of question. Okay, here standing wave ratio, maximum voltage given, power delivered, we have to calculate. Okay, so this is a 4 mark problem. And the next problem, so this is a May 2017 question. So this is a different question. A radio frequency line. So radio frequency means high frequency line. Okay, with Z naught 70 ohm is terminated by ZR, load is 115 minus J80 ohm at lambda equal to at a wavelength of 2.5 meter. Okay, so the question is find VSWR and maximum and minimum line impedances. Okay, so three things we have to calculate. One is standing wave ratio, another one is maximum and minimum line impedance. So here first you note down the given data, Z naught given, ZR given, and lambda wavelength is given. Okay, so in order to find out the reflection standing wave ratio, first we have to find out reflection coefficient. Okay, so since the standing wave ratio formula is 1 plus modulus k by 1 minus modulus k, so first we have to calculate modulus k. Okay, so the reflection coefficient k formula, you know, ZR minus Z naught by ZR plus Z naught. So you substitute 115 minus J80 minus 70 by addition of this. Okay, 115. Okay, so here 115 minus J80 plus 70. So here you just subtract this. So 45 minus J80 by the real part, you just add 185 minus J80. Okay, so then you know rectangle by rectangle division, you just do in calci. And that answer you just convert into polar. Otherwise, you convert this numerator into polar and denominator into polar. So we can get the answer 91.78 with angle this, 201.55 with angle this. Okay, then the ordinary division you did for the magnitude, so the answer is 0.45, and angle we have to subtract it. So -60.64 minus of minus plus 23.38, so the answer is -37. Okay, so from this reflection coefficient we want only the modulus k. Okay, so here the modulus k is equal to 0.45. okay, so you just take down the modulus k. After that, in standing wave ratio, you know the formula, 1 plus modulus k by 1 minus modulus k. So 1 plus 0.455 divided by 1 minus 0.455, so the answer is 2.67. okay, so after calculating standing wave ratio, here we have to find out the minimum and maximum line impedance. Okay, so the maximum line impedance formula, so already you know maximum line impedance is R naught into S. Minimum line impedance is R naught divided by S. Okay, so R naught is given in our problem 70. S is just now calculated 2.67. So you multiply, so we can get the answer 187.02 ohms. And minimum line impedance is R naught by S. So 70 divided by 2.67. So the answer is 26.2 ohms. Okay, so this is the third type of fourth type of problem. Okay, for given Z naught, ZR, we have to find out reflection coefficient as well as minimum and maximum line impedance. Okay, then the next type of question. So this is also a big question, 8-mark question. Find sending end line impedance. So sending end impedance means input impedance of a high frequency line having the characteristic impedance 50 ohm if the line is of length 1.185 lambda and terminated in a load of 110.J80. So it's a November 2016 problem. It's a 8-mark problem. Okay. So in that same, is it not given? Is it R given? And the length of the transmission line is given. Okay. So our question is to sending end impedance. Sending end impedance means input impedance. So you know the formula for the sending end impedance of high frequency line. Okay, so already we derived, you know, if we want to learn how to derive the sending end impedance, so the derivation also important 8-mark question. Okay, if you want to learn how to derive the sending end impedance, so all videos already posted in my channel. If you want to learn, I will give link in the description box, you can refer it. So the sending end impedance of high frequency liners R naught into ZR plus J R naught turn beta L by R naught plus J ZR turn beta L. Okay, so here all values are given. R naught given, ZR given, beta. Beta is nothing but 2 pi by lambda. So you know beta, the phase constant is nothing but 2 pi by lambda. Okay, 2 pi by lambda. So you see, you substitute R naught is 50. That is, Z naught is nothing but R naught, since Z naught is purely real part. Okay, 50 with Z R is 110 plus J80 plus J R naught 50 turn beta. Beta is nothing but 2 pi by lambda into length. What is the length? 1.185 lambda. Okay, so here this lambda cancel. Similarly, in denominator 50 plus J into ZR turn beta L. Okay, lambda cancel. Okay, then you just find the answer in CALC. Okay, we can get this rectangular format. And again, you just do it in your CALC, rectangle by rectangle division, or the numerator you convert into polar, denominator you convert into polar, then you do the thing. We can get the answer is 162.1 with angle 16.27 degree ohms. Okay, this is the sending end impedance. Or otherwise, in rectangle, 155.61 plus J45.43 ohms. Okay, this is the sending end impedance in rectangle form. This is in polar form. Okay, so this is the answer for this question. Okay, so for the given high frequency line, we calculated the sending end impedance. Okay, sending end impedance of the high frequency line. Okay, if the high frequency line is not mentioned, means we have to use the first unit formula. Okay, in first unit also, in ordinary transmission line also, sending end impedance is there. Okay, so input impedance formula, that is different, somewhat different. Okay, so this is for the high frequency line. Okay, so this is one of the important 8-mark problem. Okay, and the last one, The next type of question, you see, a lossless line in air having characteristics impedance 300 ohms is terminated in unknown impedance. Okay, the first voltage minimum is located at 15 centimeter from the load. The standing wave ratio is 3.3. Calculate the wavelength and terminated impedance. Okay, so here the question is, we have to find out the wavelength and terminated impedance, that is the load impedance. Okay, so one transmission line with the characteristics impedance 300 ohm is given. The first voltage minima occur at 15 centimeter from the load. Standing wave ratio given. We have to find out the load impedance, unknown load impedance. Okay, so this is a one of the 8 mark question, November 2015 question. Okay, so in order to calculate that first one, that is we have to first. So what are all the data given? SWR given. Okay, so from the SWR, first we have to calculate the reflection coefficient. Okay. So you know the formula for a reflection coefficient in terms of standing wave ratio. Okay, so k equal to s minus 1 by s plus 1. In previous, first we calculated k, then we calculated SWR. Here SWR given, we have to calculate the standing reflection coefficient. So k equal to s minus 1 by s plus 1. So 3.3 minus 1 by 3.3 plus 1, so 0.53. Okay, so K calculated. And you know the formula for K in terms of ZR, Z0. Okay, so K is nothing but ZR minus Z0 by ZR plus ZR, Z0. So here K, you know, Z0, you know. So from that, if you are rearranging, we can find the unknown impedance ZR. Okay, so for that, so you substitute the thing, K is 0.53. Equal to ZR minus Z0 is, what is the Z0 given? 300. So ZR minus 300 by ZR plus 300. So you cross multiply it and you rearrange, you collect ZR term one side. Okay. So after rearranging, we can get the load impedance ZR equal to 976 ohm. Okay. So from the given standing wave ratio, first we are calculating reflection coefficient. Then you know the reflection coefficient formula in terms of ZR, Z0. So in that, you substitute our given known quantity and we have to rearrange, okay, cross multiply and ZR term, you just take it in one side. So if you are calculating, we can get the ZR answer. Okay, then the next one, we have to find out the wavelength. So in order to find out the wavelength, on data is given, that is the voltage, the first voltage minima occurred at 15 centimeter from the load. Okay, that data is given. So you know the position of voltage minima nearest to the load is, already you know the formula, 2 beta x minimum minus pi. It is equivalent to 2n plus 1 pi. Okay, so here the pi is 0. And the first voltage minima, so that's why n is equal to 0. Okay, so you substitute pi is 0 and n equal to 0 in our previous formula. So this pi is 0 and n 0 means, so here pi. Okay, so 2 beta x minimum is equal to pi. Okay, so beta, what is beta? Beta is nothing but 2 pi by lambda. So 2 into 2 pi by lambda x minimum is equal to pi. Okay, so here, so 2 into 2 pi by lambda into x minimum. X minimum is nothing but the first voltage minima occur at a distance of, what is the data given? 15 centimeter from the load. Okay, so that's why the 15 centimeter is nothing but the distance x minimum. So you substitute 15 centimeter into 10 to the power minus 2 equal to pi. So from that, we want lambda. Okay, so you rearrange it and you just find the wavelength. The wavelength is 60 centimeter. Okay, so this is the voltage minima. Okay, this is the wherever the voltage minima occur means 2 beta into x minimum minus pi equal to 2n plus 1 pi, where n is the voltage minima occur point. Okay, n equal to 0 and the first voltage minima n is 0. Similarly, pi is the angle of our reflection coefficient. Here the angle is 0. Okay, so you just substitute pi 0, n 0 in our previous formula. And x minimum is given as 15 centimeter and rearrange it. So you just find the lambda value. Okay. So these are all the some of the 8 problems we discussed from this unit 2. Okay, so what are all the problem? So first one, the SWR calculation. Okay, if ZR given means we have to find out standing wave ratio. Okay, so in order to solve the problem, you just know the formula. S is equal to 1 plus modulus K by 1 minus modulus K. Then first we have to calculate K. Okay, then only we can calculate S. So K is nothing but ZR minus Z0 by Z0 plus Z0. This is the first problem. And the second problem, second type of problem is the characteristic impedance of high frequency line is purely resistive in nature, whose formula is square root of L by C. Okay, if L C given means how to calculate the characteristic impedance. This is the second type of question. And R L C given for high frequency line means how to calculate characteristic impedance, propagation constant, attenuation, phase constant, velocity, wavelength. Okay, so this is the big question. This type of question already we solved in the first unit. If it is a first unit, it's for general transmission line, but this is for zero dissipation line, that is lossless line or high frequency line. Okay, so the formula you may get deviation. The next question, if SWR maximum is given means how to calculate maximum resistance and the power delivered. Okay, similarly, how to calculate the maximum line impedance and minimum line impedance. Maximum line impedance formula is R max equal to R naught into S. Minimum line impedance is R naught by S. Okay, so this is the one type of problem. And another one problem, sending end impedance, that is input impedance of high frequency line calculation. This is the input impedance formula. So here R naught, ZR, L, length all given. You just substitute and you find out. This is the one type of problem. And another one problem, standing wave ratio given, we have to find out the wavelength and load impedance. Okay, so using that, using standing wave ratio, you just calculate modulus K. Then from the K value, you just rearrange and we have to find the unknown load impedance. Okay, and another one, in order to find out the wavelength at the first voltage minima, use this formula. Okay. So these are all the 8 different problems from the second unit. Okay. So thanks for watching my channel and please subscribe my channel for more videos and please press the bell notification button. Then only you can get notified once I am posting the video related to this. Okay. So if you want to learn all lecture videos related with this transmission lines and RF system in my channel, in the name of transmission lines and RF system as well as transmission line and waveguide, the separate playlist is there. In that playlist, all videos. Okay, so lecture videos for all topics as well as unit wise the 2-mark question. Okay, important Anna University 2-mark questions I solved. Then problems from each unit. Okay, so all questions maximum I solved from Anna University last 10-year question paper. So all videos already available in my channel. Okay, so if you want to learn that, I will give link for those videos in the description box also. You can refer it. Okay, so thank you. We will meet in the next video.